motherfucker. Cause all this bullshit it made me strong, motherfucker. So I pick the world up and I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, bitch, I'ma pick the world up and I'ma drop it on your fucking head. Yeah, and I could die now, rebirth, motherfucker, hop up in my space.
Okay, one of our feature bouts, one of our championship matches. Peter Maliatis on board with Ultra Tune. Ladies and gentlemen, 8 rounds of boxing for the Victorian Welterweight Championship. Would you welcome in the blue corner from Newport, Melbourne's West, the challenger. 2 professional fights, 2 wins, 1 by knockout. Fought on Adam Wilcox show in Altona North. From the Fight Fit team, Paul Fifield, the Silver Fox, Brendan the Pacer, and Mark Mullen. University undergraduate at 66.10 kilograms. Ladies and gentlemen, total black trunks. The eyes have it. Cameron Eyes. And across the ring, the red corner, trained by the legendary Murray Thompson at the Fighters Factory Blackburn. Living just down the road from the gym in Blackburn South. Former VA Bill, Victorian Junior Age Boxing Champion. In professional boxing, 5 bouts, 4 wins, only 1 loss at 65.60 kilograms. See blue trunks with white trim. Ladies and gentlemen, the reigning and defending Victorian Welterweight Champion, the Energizer Bunny, Lewis Goodrich. Referee Malcolm the Bull Bullner. Judges Mark Cook, Andrew Campbell, and Samantha Bull, the timekeeper at the bell, Damien Membry. 8 rounds of boxing, Victorian Welterweight Championship. Malcolm, it's all yours to give referees instructions.
Welcome to Centering, gentlemen. Let's have a good clean fight. I'll obey my instructions at all times. Shake hands now. Good more fighting at the bell. Good luck.
Here we go, round 1.
Lewis Goodrich here and Cameron Eyes for the Victorian Welterweight title. Lewis Goodrich the champion, Cameron Eyes the hungry challenger, trained by Paul Fifield in the blue shorts. Both fighters quick, sharp and mean business.
Yeah, great matchup here, Peter. And looking at both fighters, Cameron Eyes a bit less experienced but an undefeated record with 2 wins from his 2 fights. And Lewis Goodrich, the champion, the reigning champion, with 4 wins and 1 loss from his 5 fights. How do you see this matchup panning out?
It's 50-50. That's what it's all about. These guys are going to enjoy the contest. That's as simple as that. You cannot enjoy more than a 50-50 contest, and that's what these guys want, and that's what boxing's all about. If you can get some 50-50 fights happening, there's nothing better.
It's exciting. It's an exciting bout planned here, and looking at the start already, both fighters seem quite explosive, a lot of speed on display.
Look, both fighters are trying to start quick, obviously, and that's what it's all about, and trying to get the upper hand, because you know, if you get a good start in boxing, it's half the battle. Both guys wailing away here.
The referee breaks up a little bit of a tangle, but
Lewis Goodrich looks a lot like Michael Katsidis, doesn't he?
He does. That's a good call. He just needs a tattoo on his back.
Whoa, Cameron Eyes!
Cracking left hand by Eyes, and that really, really tested Goodrich there.
Cameron Eyes, trained by Paul Fifield, and Lewis Goodrich, trained by Murray Thompson.
And really good side movement there by Eyes. He's certainly been able to negate the offense so far of Goodrich.
Yes, look, both fighters have got nice, crispy punches, haven't they?
Yeah, they do. And it's going to be interesting to see this fight as it continues, because some heavy-handed blokes these two are.
They certainly are. Good call, Shree. This fight has got fireworks written all over it. This has got a real, real fight of the year. Look about it.
It does. And these are the kind of fights that you don't think on paper are going to be, that big of a spectacle. But these are the type of fights at the end of the year, when you look at the review of all the fights that have happened, will come up in the mix as one of the best.
Look, they both started fast for an 8-round fight. There's just been zero filling out process. That's the only thing I'm worrying about. There's going to be a moment where they're going to have a flat spot and suck it all up. They can't keep going at this pace.
Yeah, well, it's a good point, Peter. And
10 seconds in round
looking
one
at both fighters so far, you would say that the edge so far this round has gone to Cameron, nice?
Oh, it's a hard one to score. Maybe, yeah.
Round one, very competitive boxing. Cameron Eyes, Lewis Goodrich. Jimmy Vegas, how are you? Part of the big Ultra Gym team.
Gee, this fight now, it's starting to smell a fight of the year. Something sneaky. There's that sneaky smell sometimes you get that you know two gladiators in there, not willing to give an inch, not asking for an inch, and the contest just right in front of them.
Yeah, I'm a bit away, but a great shot by Cameron Eyes.
But just looking at Lewis Goodrich, there's so much Katsidis about him.
Yeah, he's got that vibe about him. Well, so far, I think that the cleaner shots have been landed by Cameron Eyes, but both fighters have really had their moments in the first round.
And it's going to be one of those fights, you can just see it now, it's going to be a nightmare to score.
Yeah, we look at the records of both fighters, obviously Goodrich's had the more fights, so we've seen him in an 8-rounder against Terry Dehan, which he won comfortably. And then he also was scheduled to fight 10 rounds against Todd Kidd. Would you say that in terms of stamina, the edge would go to Goodrich?
Not really, because Cam Eyes, trained by Paul Fifield, he gets him fit. You just don't know. I don't think it's going to be stamina that's going to determine the contest of this fight.
You think that we're in a chance for a stoppage or an early night here?
No way. Unless it's cuts, I think we're going the distance. Both guys are just so fit, well trained, and tuned out that they mean business. It's as simple as that.
Yeah, and now we see Goodrich on the offense, and he's really landed a few good shots, but nice counters there by Cameron Eyes.
Yeah, look, Eyes now, sneaky right hand there from Eyes. This is as evenly matched as you can get. It's hard to really pick an out-and-out guy that's where you could say, well, you know, it's going to be a hard one, you know?
I think, it definitely looks an even matchup. And you look at their physiques, and both guys very, very cut up and look, they've really made the welterweight limit and look raring to go.
Yeah, for sure. And it's, Cameron Eyes there getting some good moments. In close, Eyes looks sharp, doesn't he?
He does. He looks pretty explosive. He comes in with those short hooks like he's just done there. And I think he's caught Goodrich a few times on his unawares.
Paul Fifield just trains him to the minute. And also, Goodrich trained by... the body shot hurt him there. He's maybe feeling something. It just took the win out of him for a moment.
It's nearly the end of the round, so he might be happy that we hear the bell.
What a round, come on! Round two, punch for punch. Get me with your best shot, far away. Jimmy Vegas will make the presentation, Jimmy. Round three, scheduled for 8.
And here we go again. Cameron Eyes versus Lewis Goodrich for the Victorian State welterweight title. And we've seen quite an explosive start to this fight, and Cameron Eyes looks to have landed some of the more heavier shots, but both fighters looking really good here, and we're in for a cracking 8 rounds.
Oh, we certainly are. I mean, if the first two rounds anything to go by, it's just going to be a rip snorter.
Yeah, and we saw a nice left hook there by Eyes, but a very nice explosive counter there by Goodrich.
This is the kind of fights the crowd love to see. Two evenly matched fights where you don't know who's going to win.
Yeah, and we've seen two local guys as well. Do you feel like the local component to the fight where, you know, Jim's prides might be a bit on the line here? Would you say that that also adds to the event?
Look, any local derby adds a bit extra to the contest, doesn't it? Because it's bragging rights. You're going to have to see the guy at another promotion and what have you. So, I mean, when you fight interstate, you don't see him again. Here, these guys have to front up to each other at other promotions and see each other. And, you know, you don't want to have a notch up against you when it's a local derby. It just means that much more extra, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, and we're starting to see a bit of blood coming out of Goodrich's nose.
Yeah.
And I wonder if that's going to distract him a bit as the fight continues.
Don't think so. At this level, as long as it's sort of cut above the eye, you know, a bit of claret from the nose at the pros, it's pretty much, you know, what you expect going for a fight, title fight as well. He's got a good corner too. I'm sure Murray will have the adrenaline going and up the nostrils, mate, with the adrenaline and the butts, and it normally stops it pretty quick.
Yeah, he's well, I guess it shows that, you know, some pretty good shots have been landed, and we're showing some, you know, some real actions taking place.
Oh, for sure. It's a big left hook there. Cameron Eyes is starting to be impressive, isn't he?
He is. He is. He looks real, especially in close range. He's got that explosiveness that I think is really catching Goodrich by surprise.
And looking at him, he just looks like the guy from next door, you know, the plain-looking kid. But he's got a bit of fire in that belly, hasn't he?
He does, yeah. He does. It's a good point, Peter. And we are really seeing a real determined performance here.
Lewis Goodrich, though, I'm sure he's going to have to dig deep here to save his title, because he's not going to just hand it on a plate, that's for sure.
He's not, and he lands a nice combination. They're working the body and head, but Cameron Ice comes back pretty strongly.
Oh, big body shot there.
And a very good round there.
We welcome the Pretty Boy George. Pretty Boy George from the Hawthorn Football Club. Greg Rose and assistant Murray Thompson. Seconds out, round four.
Round four, have you scored it so far?
I've got Cameron Eyes ahead, and I think that he's landed the heavier shots. The cleaner shots has been by him. I think it's been competitive in most parts, but I've got Eyes in front. How about you, Pete?
Yeah, but a pretty close fight, but Eyes in front at the moment. Goodrich needs to turn the tide. Oh, this is toe-to-toe. This is what it's all about, Shree.
Yeah, this is pretty heavy-handed stuff right here.
Not 1 inch given, not 1 inch asked.
Yeah, this is brilliant. And this is, it goes back to what you're saying, Peter, as a potential Fight of the Year candidate.
With rounds like that, it's, you know, it's keeping the crowd active, and it's keeping the crowd really entertained.
You feel like every single person here in attendance is really glued to this fight, and why wouldn't they be?
Oh, nice shots. Goodrich is starting to get his work rate up, isn't he? He sort of feels that the fight could be slipping away.
I think so, yeah, that's a good point.
And the work rate's starting to get thrown up.
Yeah, this round in particular, he's stepped it up a bit more, and I think he realises that rounds might be in the first three rounds that he might not have won, you know, he might not have won all of them, or might have lost all of them. So he really wants to get on top of this fight now. You look at Cameron Eyes, and his trunks do appear a bit high. What are your thoughts on the height of his trunks?
No, they're okay. Oh, some heavy clubbing shots. Both fighters landing. One thing I'm noticing here, when these guys launch, they launch. Like they say, I'm going to throw a punch. They don't care if they're going to get countered. They're just planting their feet and really wailing away, and it's making for a great fight.
Yeah, it is, definitely. And I think, you know, the first three rounds were quite explosive, but I feel like this round they've taken it up another notch.
They have, and that's what the good pros do. That's why we're talking. I can't wait for round five, six, seven, and eight. This is going to be a cracker. Definitely lock in your seatbelts and get ready for a nice ride in this fight.
Yeah, and neither fighter really looked like they were going to have gone down. I think they looked pretty solid and durable as well as explosive. So, yeah, the 8-round distance is looking quite a likely one here.
Oh, for sure. For sure. The crowd's starting to really enjoy the contest now, aren't they?
Yeah, I think so. And they're really starting to appreciate, you know, how close a contest it really is.
10 seconds.
This has been a very competitive fourth round, hasn't it?
Certainly. And
Goodrich's punch output's improved.
Definitely. And he might have taken that round.
Yeah, yeah.
Round four.
Round five. And this fight is definitely heading up, Sri Visayasam.
It is indeed, and we've seen four really, really high-paced rounds, and heading into the fifth, both fighters have had quite good moments, and it's going to be interesting to see how they hold up the pace going into the second half of the fight.
I think they'll be fine. Both guys are just so fit, you can just see it, that they'll go 8 rounds easy.
And you did mention their trainers really being good at working on durability, stamina, and that capacity to fight the full distance with full pace.
Oh, both of them have done the work. There's no doubt about that. Oh, some big shots there landed. This is what it's all about, this close infighting.
It is. And
we just got sprinkled with some blood shriek. Oh, okay.
That shows how close
we are to the action.
Yeah, indeed.
I'll send Lewis Goodrich my laundry bill. I'll just find out where he lives.
Yeah. And we saw Goodrich really push Eyes against the ropes, and he started to land some quite heavy shots, but Eyes has responded in kind, and really no one's really taken a backward step here.
No, they haven't. They haven't. Goodrich seems strong now, doesn't he? He's starting to work into the fight now.
Yeah, I think so. It's been a different Goodrich ever since we started the fourth round, and the momentum might be starting to head towards his direction.
It could. This has been an evenly matched fight. It's give and take a round or two. There's nothing in it, is there?
Yeah, I'd say there's anything in it either. And look, as a promoter, Peter, these are the kind of fights that you love to sort of match up and see eventuate.
Oh, this is what the crowd loves. This is what it's all about. The third man in the ring, Malcolm Bulmer, refereed many a world title fight, big WBC referee.
Yeah, and he refereed the recent Mundine Rabchenko fight back in Melbourne in November.
No, he wasn't a referee for that, he was a judge. Was from Belgium, I think, or Sweden. One of the...
Yeah, that's right, yeah, that is correct. Yeah, the judge. Yeah, he was the judge that was the final scorecard they read.
He was, yeah. Experienced judge and referee. I think Sri Lankan heritage.
Okay, right, yeah, he was the Olympian now, wasn't he?
Yeah. Sri, you must be upset with the cricket, or you're copping it pretty sweet?
Oh, no, a bit disappointed. I was hoping India had put in a bit stronger
Once
performance.
Once Kohli went, it was just pack up the bags and...
Yeah, well... Yeah, that 3 wickets in that space of 20 minutes really, really ultimately cost him the game.
Okay, better not get sidetracked here as we go into the fifth round. And
another explosive round by both fighters.
Round six, and we wish it was a 10-rounder.
Yeah, well,
I want this fight to end.
Maybe we'll see a rematch in the future for a national title.
Who knows? Who knows?
And Cameron Eyes has really flipped his intensity going into the start of this round. And both fighters, though, have really stepped up the pace at different stages. You don't feel that either fighter has been dominated in terms of work rate.
No, they haven't, and it's going to be a hard fight to score. It's just going to be an unbelievably hard fight to score.
Do you feel that being a reigning champion, Goodrich has any sort of advantages in being the reigning title holder?
I don't think it's going to play much part in it. I really don't. I think the fight's going to be won in the seventh and eighth round. I think that's where someone's going to pull away, or has to pull away, to have a clear win, because at the moment it seems to be seesawing a bit. I mean, Ives won the early rounds. Goodrich has come back with great work rate, and there's nothing in it.
Yeah. I think this round, I know we're only less than a minute into it, but the pace seems to have slowed.
Well, they had to. It was too breakneck. I mean, they were fighting it, basically without any breaks. Now this is a round where you could take off and have a breather, but they won't.
And a cracking left, a right hand there by Cameron Ives, having Goodrich against the ropes. But he has been cautioned by the referee there.
This fight's also been fought in great spirit too, hasn't it? Both fighters really honest with each other and great sportsmen and, no illegal blows, no holding. They just want to fight.
Yeah, it's a good call, Peter. We haven't really seen much of tying each other down. It's been very... It's been kept at a nice distance, and when they've come in close, they've been broken up pretty quickly.
Great call. Goodrich now on the outside, using the jab, sticking and moving.
Yeah,
mixing it up a bit.
Yeah, that's right. He's changed tack slightly, and maybe Cameron Ives might like that though.
10 seconds.
Nice body shot there by Cameron Ives, and a very good round once again.
Maybe just score that shot.
I'll give that round to Cameron Ives.
Sunday, the World Cup, Australia versus New Zealand. Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round 6, Murray Thompson called the fight off. Lewis Goodrich, a nasal injury. Would you congratulate the new Victorian welterweight champion, Cameron Ives? Jimmy Vegas on behalf of Ultra Tune to make the belt presentation. How about 3 cheers for Cameron? Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. Bad luck, Lewis Goodrich. Well done, Cameron. It was a grueling fight.
Yeah, it was a good, tough fight. I wanted Lewis for the fight. Comes in here, puts his body on the line, like every other fighter does. So thanks for the fight, mate. Thanks, Peter, many artists for putting on the show. Great show. Good crowd here, good turnout, which is always good. Helps the fight game going. Also, thanks to my corner, Paul. Huge help. All the guys from the gym. Graham, of course, in behind me and back me. Thank you very much, mate. Also, all the fans and my girlfriend, of course. Couldn't do without you. Thanks, guys.
Okay,